Hi, it's me, Joyce, just talking, just singing. And I'm here today, although I didn't think I would be here today to do this vlog because I was going to punish myself, which is something that borderlines do. You may know that I have borderline personality disorder. Not something I want to define myself by. And certainly, you know, with treatment and everything, people can get better. But unfortunately for me, because I was diagnosed at 26, I didn't really get treatment, proper treatment, until I was 58, down 66. So I've had to go through my life basically winging it, because there's no medication for borderline personality disorder. Anyway, that being said, I don't define myself by that, but there are things that we don't do well, because people have different kinds of illnesses, whether it's Parkinson's or diabetes or whatever people have. You know, cancer is a terrible thing, heart disease, all kinds of illnesses you can think of, arthritis. There are things that people can do and things that people can't do. And when it comes to mental illness, certainly there are things that when people with mental health issues just don't do well. And unless they get proper treatment and able to work things through. And but for me, it's relationships. It really is. Relationships, whether it's friends, family, romantic. It's always been a challenge. A big challenge. And I just had to do something very difficult lately, which was something that I actually deal with very badly, which is, I guess, there are abandonment issues and loneliness and isolation, trust issues. But I was the one who did the rejection. But they say rejection is God's protection. And sometimes we need to push away things that aren't working in our lives. And I had to do that. I had to do it with someone who's actually struggling themselves. I won't go into detail, but it hurt them and it hurt me. And it wasn't necessarily romantic or anything, or family or friends. I can't really describe the situation, but it was with someone who I'd hoped to help. I had to stop helping for my own reasons. Anyway, but when I do something like that and I see the person's really hurting, I tend to want to punish myself. So I was not going to be here today to do a vlog. I was going to say, well, I'm never doing any vlogs anymore. I'm just not going to do it anymore. I don't deserve to do these vlogs. I hurt someone. And I also said things to myself like, I'm just not going to go out anymore. It's winter. I'm just going to stay in. I'll go for the odd walk. I'll go pick up my groceries. I'll shop. I'll cook. I'll keep myself alive, but I'm not going to bother seeing anybody, because I just cause chaos in people's lives, and that's not good. So I told myself that, and I said, well, you know, my family's busy, so I'm happy for them. They're going to live their lives just fine out there. They don't need me. I'll be there for them when they need me, but, you know, I just basically going to cut off family, friends, my shul. Not going to shul anymore. No. I'll give my donation every month, but I will not go to shul. Not going. Not gonna be in community with people. No. Not going to talk to anyone. Boom. Bear in a cave. Well, thank God I took my vitamins this morning. Made myself an omelet, had a cup of coffee, excuse me. It always helps. A little honey, a little cream. But, and I shook myself out. I got myself into the shower, took a very long, hot shower, let that water just come over me. Washed my hair really well, blew dry it, well, scrunchy dried it, whatever I do. I thought, Today, I'm wearing my leopard dress or my cheetah dress, whatever, my animal print dress. And being a Leo, I really vibe to this. I thought I'm going to put on some nice jewelry that my dear friend Elena Morfea gave me. This beautiful necklace. Oops. And this, let me show you, this lovely, lovely bracelet. You know? And, of course, I'm wearing my Kim Smiley cuff, which I love, which I bought myself for Hanukkah. I thought I'm going to get dressed, and I'm going to come on, and I'm going to do this vlog. Because it's really important to shake that off. And it's important to shake things off, get your parasympathetic nervous system working again, not going into fight or flight mode, not going into hiding, which is something I do. I've done this in the past, just completely isolated. And I've been back on Facebook for a while, just lately, just to put up my music and the vlogs, and also on LinkedIn and YouTube. But I've had people come to me and say, "Where have you been?" You know? And away. Just away. But I'm back. And I'm not gonna go into hiding again. No. Not gonna go into hiding. Nope. Don't wanna do that. Because that's unhealthy. So I'm a healthier person now. And these vlogs have really been helping me to come out of my shell. So I'm kind of like an extroverted introvert. Anyway, so I just wanted to let you guys know that when it's okay, I'm telling myself this too, but it's okay to say no. It's okay to change your mind about doing something for somebody if it's not working anymore. And it's not always perfect timing. Nothing is. Where's perfect timing? You know, it's never a perfect time to say goodbye to someone or to say, I'm sorry, I can't do this anymore. I thought I could, but I can't really help you anymore. There's, you know, because of course that person is going to be like, what? What you can't do? What? Well, I don't understand. What happened? What happened? I got to scramble. I got to change things around for myself, blah, 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 whatever. And you look and you go, oh my gosh, maybe I shouldn't have said that. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Maybe I shouldn't have asked them to do that. And I tell them I'm not able to help anymore. And all of a sudden, like, there's no rush. You can take your time. Like, I did give this person time to find alternate resources. But sometimes you just got to say no. Sometimes you got to just say, enough is enough, right? So that's what I did. But I felt terrible. And then I thought about how I want to feel in relationships in general, you know, like, not that this was romantic. It's just because sometimes you feel lonely and you reach out and help people because by helping people, it just makes you feel like you got all these people around you, you know, and that you're doing something. But sometimes it's just riding on the crest of the waves, and inside you just don't feel that great. You just feel kind of empty and lonely and lost. And the emptiness feeling is very, very borderline. But you don't have to have that to feel that way. No. I thought, because I sing a song every time I do one of these things, and I'm putting on my happy face. Because otherwise I'll cry. Because I really don't like to hurt people. It's not in my I don't like to. I know I have hurt people in the past. Because I've made snap decisions. Just out of the blue, it seems to them. But it's been percolating in here for a while. I just didn't communicate it. Very important to communicate things to people before you give them a heads up. So that's a lesson I'm learning, that's for darn sure. Anyway, so how would I like to feel in a romantic relationship? Because, heck, let's go for broke. Not broke. Makes you feel really rich, you know. But, just wondering what I'm going to sing. Ah, I think this song would work. It's a Frank Sinatra song, the great, late, great Frank Sinatra, who left us a legacy of beautiful, beautiful work. And what a voice, and what a delivery, and his phrasing, impeccable. When I listen to Frank Sinatra songs, and I try to sing along with him, first of all, it's not in my key. We don't sing in the same key, but surprising phrasing, like you think that this is going to be next, and then there's a little gap, or he does it a little, sings a little earlier, whatever. It's like phrasing is so important to singers. My phrasing is not that great. I think I sing the songs pretty much the way they were written. But here goes. So it's not going to sound like Frank. But this is just to bring my spirits up, and hopefully your spirits up too. Feeling a little low. This is a great song, an oldie from the vault. Okay. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I want to go play hide and seek. I want to go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon. You and I are just like a couple of tots running across the meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. Bells to be rung and a wonderful fling to be flung. And even when I'm old and gray, cause I'm not right now, I'm gonna feel the way I do today. Cause you make me feel so. You make me feel so. You make me feel so. Ba, ba. Ba-ba-ba, young. Gotta do those tags at the end, eh? Three tags. I thought I'd do bum-bum. Need a bass in there. Anyway, yeah. I'm 66. Still young. Hey, I got a cousin through marriage that, he's 96. Picks me up in his red car, and we go for coffee and muffins. Yeah. And he's great. And he says, hey, I got friends who are over 100. Yeah, he does. And so we're still young, no matter how old you are. There's another great song. Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart. Another great song. Yeah. And everybody loves somebody sometime, Dean Martin. Go put on some of those songs right now. I think I'm going to. Have a good day. Enjoy yourself. Even if you're alone, it's okay. I don't know where that cat of mine is. Meow. Oh, she's sleeping on the chair. One of her favorite spots. Anyway, thank you very much for joining me for another Just Joyce, Just Talking, Just Singing. And thank you for listening to me as I talked about almost giving up. Don't give up. Not a good idea. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm. No, I'm not going underground again. I'm staying above, and I'm going to be in the sun, and I'm going to shine my light. Just shine your light, and the right people will see it and want to be part of that light. They will. And never get used or abused. And never offer something you really can't follow through with. And that's something I did. I couldn't. You know, only do what you're certain of. So, we'll end this edition of Joyce Just Talking, Just Singing with that magical number 42. The answer to all the questions in the universe. So 42, Have a wonderful holiday season, all of you. I'll be back probably maybe sometime later this week to talk about my grandmothers. Anyway, you take care and have a wonderful day. Bye for now.